जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण, our humble pranams to all the assembled Vaishnavas.
How much ever they tried to push the bulls and move the cart did not move. Then the devotees prayed to Vrindadevi and said, why your cart is not moving? Vrindadevi said, I don't want to leave Raj and go out. You know, but the devotee said, even Krishna has left and gone. Why you are knowing, not coming? And Krishna and Vrindadevi smilingly said, he has multiple wives and multiple girlfriends. Maybe he wanted to see newer and newer girlfriends. You know, that is why Krishna is going out of Raja in searching of beautiful girls. But we have only one master, so I am not moving. And saying this, Vrindadevi stayed forever in Kamyavan. So in memory to this pastime, there are three replica temples of Govindji, Gopinathji and Madan Mohan in Kamyavan also. Kamyavan also has got three replica temples and the original Vrindadevi. So Vrindadevi is the authority of devotional seva. Even though so many acharyas have given explanation for bhakti, Srila Prabhupada gave a beautiful explanation. Bhakti means seva. You know, sincerely, lovingly, not out of compulsion, not out of force, lovingly serving Krishna, you know, and Vaishnavas. And Vrindadevi is the in charge of it. So Vrindadevi had to sanction, you know, what is bhakti, what we perform is devotion. Our devotional service have to be sanctioned by Vrindadevi. So Vrindadevi, every day, she has thousands and thousands of parrots. You know, and the female parrot's leader is male parrot is Shuka and the female parrot is Sarim. And these two parrots had 108 parrots below them. The male parrot had 108 below them and the female parrot had 108 below them. And Vrindadevi will send all the parrots, you know, morning in all the 12 vanas. And the parrots will come back and say, to report to their leader. And Shuka will decide, okay, let us go to Madhuvana today. Then Sarika will ask, why? Because Madhuvana today's flowers are dripping honey. You know, mango tree is dripping mango juice on the jackfruit and the jackfruit is dripping on this thing. And these fruits don't have seeds, don't have skin. And all the honey is mixed in Yamuna and the bumblebees are there and this and that. Then immediately Sari will say, that is all from Madhuvan. You know what is in Kamyavan? Today, all the trees have flowered with, one tree has only rubies. Another tree had emerald as flowers. Another tree had diamonds as flowers. And the whole place is dazzling and beautiful. And the birds. So let us go to Kamyavan. So every day there is an argument, you know, selecting which one is better than the other one. And finally, Vrindadevi will come. And with the help of Purnamasi, Vrindadevi will decide, okay, let us go to Kamyavan. And immediately the parrots will scatter and go to Kamyavan and arrange Nikunja, the flower beds and, you know, jhulas and, you know, they do everything. And Radharani and Krishna will go there with the gopis to have pastime. So Radharani, Vrindadevi's presence is simply to arrange for leelas. That is why, instead of serving Krishna directly, serving pure souls of Krishna is much, much more wonderful. So the Manjaris will serve gopis, and the gopis will serve the eight principal gopis, and the eight principal gopis will serve Radharani, and the Radharani will serve Krishna. None of the Manjaris will directly approach Krishna, nor the gopis. And Vrinda Devi was doing this day and continuously. And Radharani became so happy. And Radharani thought, I have never repaid anything to Vrinda Devi. So today I'm going to repay. And instead of Vrinda Devi arranging, without Vrinda Devi's knowledge, Radharani arranged everything in Kamyavan for one day. Radharani arranged the garden, the flowers, and the honey, and everything. And when Vrinda Devi came, she was surprised. Radharani has arranged a million times better than what Vrinda Devi arranged. Vrinda Devi was taken aback. And Vrinda Devi was asked to sit in the throne. And from nowhere, Lalita and Vishakha, they brought Krishna dragging, pulled him and made him sit in the singhasan with Vrinda Devi. And Vrinda Devi was so shy. She was feeling so shy to sit in with Krishna in front of Radharani. And Krishna was feeling blushed, you know. And the beautiful Leela took place. And in Kamyavan, Radharani crowned Vrinda Devi as a queen, you know. So one day, Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami went there. And they were writing and discussing Krishna Katha. And all of a sudden, they felt thirsty. A beautiful girl appeared there in Kamyavan. Very beautiful girl. And she came with a pot of milk and gave it to Rupa Goswami. And Rupa Goswami understood Sanatan Goswami is very thirsty. So Sanatan Goswami, Rupa Goswami offered that milk to Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami is Rupa Goswami's brother as well as spiritual master. So Sanatan Goswami tasted this milk and he said, I have never tasted anything like this in my entire life. This is not a normal milk from this material world. Who gave you this? And they went and searched and they found Vrinda Devi came as a young, beautiful girl and served them milk. And Sanatan Goswami became so upset. He thought, we are supposed to serve them. We are supposed to serve the gopis. We are supposed to serve Krishna. We are supposed to serve the dust of Raja. And what is happening here? They are coming and serving. How is that? And with tears, with such a gratitude, Sanatan Goswami was sipping that milk and Rupa Goswami was drinking that milk with so much of gratitude. So that is why we should feel very thankful because we are not at all qualified to discuss about Krishna, Gopas, Gopis, Vrindavan. What qualification do we have? And we all know we are demons within, deep within we are demons. We have anger, we have lust. We are jealousy about fellow devotees. You know, we are fighting for name, fame, glory. So many things we have. And we know all these things. So we don't deserve this mercy. It is all pure blessings of Vaishnavas, Guru, Prabhupada, Parampara. We should be very thankful, filled with gratitude. You know, see in Vrindavan, when pure devotees go, the gopis, Radharani, Krishna is trying to serve them and protect them. Service is the underlying secret of bhakti. Apratihata. You know, what is that? Savaipumsam parodharmo yato bhakti radokshini. Ahaituki apratihata. Unconditioned and undivided devotional service. You know, unconditioned. And, you know, without expecting any result. So today, second day, actually, we could cover only 50% of, Kamyavan. There are many, many pastimes in Kamyavan. So anyway, we pray to the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami and Sanat Kun Goswami, especially to Vrinda Devi. Vrinda Devi, this particular deity is a very, very ancient deity. We pray. And, so actually Vajranabha Maharaja installed this deity. So there was a king, anyway, I will just rush it up. There was a king called Kamasena. So when he heard all these wonderful pastimes of Kamyavan, he came and renovated 84 tirthas. Then he built 84 temples.
and he constructed 84 pillars where once Nanda Baba's palace was there. So this particular place is also called as Chaurasi Khamba. You know, 84 pillars. There are 84 pillars all built by this king called Kamasena, depicting these beautiful leelas of Kamyavan. He restored 84 tirthas and 84 temples. So once you go to Kamyavan, it is equal that you have gone to Prayag, you have gone to Gaya, you have gone to Rameshwaram, you have gone to Badrinath, Kedarnath. Everything is staying in Kamyavan. So let us very deeply pray that our heart should be pure in this lifetime. The lust, the root of lust should disappear. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Vrindavan Dham ki jai. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu. I'll unmute everybody. Hare Krishna. Now we can unmute and then ask any queries, or if you have any takeaway, maybe you can share your takeaway.
I will ask one question.
Yes, Prabhu.
It is not question actually.
Yeah.
I got my own doubt. Since you are beautifully explaining everything, I thought I can take this opportunity to know this from the authentic person. The doubt is actually, Jayadeva has lived in Katak in Orissa. He has made 24 Ashtapadi, mainly a Rasa Leela of Krishna and Radha. Yeah. Where was that place actually? All those points took place.
Okay. So in Vrindavan, especially Jayadeva has returned this very deep, intimate pastimes in Ashtapati as well as Gita Govindam, these two books. So most of these intimate leelas has happened in 12 different vanas. In one vana, for example, where Barsana is there, Radharani will show anger, false anger. You know, that is, how do you explain that in English? I don't know. False anger, you know, out of deep love, purposely, you know, when the lover turns her face from the beloved and the beloved keeps coming, begging, you know, that kind of leela in that vana. And in Vrindavan, they had deep conjugal love in Vrindavan. And this is like some other place where Radharani will crack jaws, some other place she will shed tears. So in all the 12 vanas, different bhavas have taken place. And rasasthalis are mainly two. One is Nidhivana and the second one is Seva Kunj. These two places are the prominent places where Rasalila happened. But different bhavas had happened in 12 vanas. The 12 vanas, 7 on left side of Yamuna and 5 on the right side of Yamuna. So Yamuna goes in between these 12 vanas. So all the 12 vanas had different bhavas, different kinds of love expression between Radharani and Krishna. Is that clear?
Clear, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, anybody has any queries or any point to?
Yeah, Satish Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu.
Can you scroll the different screens from 1, 2, 3? Starting with 1. Little slowly, Prabhu, little slowly. Can you go back?
First, from the first.
Can you go a little slow?
The previous one. Yes.
Yeah. So, Prabhu, can you mention to me again what is Deepavali?
Okay. Prabhu Jim, this is the place where Lakshmanji temple, that all that leelas we explained, This is King Kamasena.
Can you, Deepika, please mute. Hare Krishna, please mute if you're not speaking.
Okay. So Prabhuji, this is Maharaja Kamasena, the temple where Narsingadev is there. And on one side, you can see Prahlad. Another side is Lakshmana. Lakshmana, Prahlad and Narsingadev is there. This is very close to Ramasetu Bridge, which is there in Kamyavan. Okay, so the Leelas took place. And one day when Nanda Baba, I told in the beginning of the class, when Nanda Baba and Krishna, when they had all these arguments, and Krishna showed false anger to Nanda Baba. So that night, Nanda Baba will take Krishna on his lap and tell him Ramayana stories and tell him Narasimha stories and all these things. And actually, they all appeared there. Ram Lakshman appeared in Ram Setu. Narsingha appeared there. And Varahadev appeared. Badrinath appeared. All these deities appeared in Kamyavan. That is why Kamyavan is the mother of all the Tirthas. Okay.
What is the meaning of Dida?
Prabhuji?
Prabhuji, this is actually a paternal grandmother of Krishna.
Dida. The name of the name of that person?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Dida is the name of the person?
Yes, Prabhuji. Didavali is the name of the person. It's a paternal grandmother of Krishna.
Okay. Next.
Yeah. Next. Okay, this is just one of the ISKCON devotees there. Kadamba one means Kadamba tree is there. This is on the bank of one more kund, which is little below that Vyomasura cave. You know, this is where one beautiful pastime happened. It is also called Lukluki Pond. Lukluki Pond means all the boys will assembled on the bank of the pond. And Krishna will dive inside the water, deep inside the water, and pull the cowherd boy's legs. So once, when gopis all came to take bath, Krishna went inside this Lukluki pond, and he was about to drag Radharani's feet. That's how they play. But Radharani could see one peacock feather is moving around here and there in the water. So Radharani could identify Krishna and she went out of this Lukluki pond. So this is the place where all the gopas had these kind of pastimes.
Next.
Vyasdeva. In Badrinath, the Vyasdeva appeared. Vyasdeva Kuha is there and said that's where he has written Mahabharata and Bhagavat and all this. Vyasa Kuha is also there in Badrinath.
Good. Next.
Yes, this is what the trekking, little tedious trekking is there, but not this way. There's a proper way. This is some devotees there. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. This is where Narnarayana Rishis appeared in Badrinath. And the three deities are there. The person who is paying Namaskara is Uddhava. Uddhava, Nara and Narayana. So all the three are there in the altar. Left side is Nararishi, middle is Narayana and right is Uddhava.
Good.
Yes, this is the deity of Lakshman there. Lakshmana deity. This is actually Badrinath's picture from Himalaya. This is not the Badrinath. This is Himalaya Badrinath. Or, Yeah. Next, Prabhu. This is also Kedarnath from Himalaya. But the Shivalinga, Kedarnath Shivalinga is there in Kamyavan. The left side Kedarnath temple is from Himalaya. The right side Shivalinga is in Kamyavan. This is Kamyavan.
Good, right. Good. Please. Next.
Next problem. Yeah, this is a picture of Lord Sri. And this is original Jaipur Gopinath deity. Chaurasikamba. Yeah, these are the Radha Govinda Dev deities in Kamyavan. And this is the only biggest temple in Kamyavan. Whereas Radha Gopinath ji and Radha Madan Mohan, they are inside somebody's house actually.
Mm.
They are very fortunate. It is inside somebody's house. And this is only there. There is only one temple in the common town. and this is Radha Govind Dev, and in this temple only Brinda Devi Treti is also there. Yeah, Prabhu. Next. Yeah, this is the Brinda Devi. Next. Kameshwar Mahadev, very famous in Kamyavan, and one among the five protectors of Vrajdham. Next. Bimala Kund, all the Sindh Raja's daughters' tears turned into Bimala Kund. Next. Next, Prabhu. Yeah, this is Ram Setu. Then, this is the sliding place. All the gopas will slide and ISKCON devotees will slide. Next. Vyomasura cave. On top of this cave, there is Krishna's footprint. You know, and very beautiful is Balaram's Charan. The picture is not there. Balaram's Charan. When earth shook, Balaram gave a kick and holded it. Balaram Charan is very beautiful. Vyomasura, next. Vanabhojan, next. Hare Krishna.